the day is a Sanshi group, Ryukyu, Koten, Ongaku, Kenkyuu, Choichi, Kai, Hawaii. I'm sorry, I missed the name. Ryukyu, Koten, Afuso, Ongaku, Kenkyuu, Choichi, Kai, Hawaii. Still learning. Afuso, Choichi, Kai, USA is a classical Sanshi group that was started by Japan National Living Treasure, Choichi Terukuna Sensei. The group is a part of Afuso, Yensei, Kai, Ho, Ishibu, and is the first chapter outside of Okinawa. Currently, they have over 200 members who reside in Hawaii, Oahu, Maui, Kauai, and Hawaii Islands, as well as in Los Angeles, Washington State, and New York.
I say, Ryukyu, Koten, Afuso, Ongaku, Kenkyuu, Choichi, Kai, Hawaii, minasama, dozo!
Thank you.
It's really inspiring because I think the youngest person I saw, a young girl, She was 10 years old, and she's learning Sanskrit. And you have some that are in their 80s.
Yeah, I'm in my 80s.
It's never too young. You're never too young to learn without Sanskrit. You're never too
young.
Yeah, that's true. So, now, Kongfu.
Yeah.
This is something that has, I think, helped. It's also a big financial commitment. So tell us about Kongfu and why it's so important to have our students participate in this.
Well, what I want to say is that they participate in Kongfu, they come back with a feeling like you go to Okinawa, you show them Okinawa, Japanese speaking guys do. To them, it's like something like a faraway dream. They go, they do it. Hey, I did it. Hey, I can do this. And then, yeah, that's all. And then, so, they want to continue. And I think that was a big reason for our participation with all of these guys. And, they wanted to go to the next level. And, you know, sometimes, as much as possible, like I tell my students, we only want to send you to Okinawa only if we really, really know in your pants. But once in a while, you might not have that. But you know, the lucky is that all of them keep on trying to do their pants. So
they practice and practice here in Hawaii with your mini sensei.
Correct.
And then they still, when they go to Okinawa, when you're able to go to Okinawa, they train more. At the school, at the head school?
At the head school. Yeah. But what happened with Corona here was that you can't go to Okinawa anymore.
Right.
So, I went to meet with the president, now he was the chairman of the board at the time, and asked him that we can't let Corona stop us, so let's find out a way to do this virtually. So from 2021 and 22, Shinjin Show was done virtually.
Shinjin Show, the first level?
Yeah. And, the first year we could do, they would allow us to do Shinjin Yushu Show, Afuso, virtually. But from 2022, I said,
they want to hear it in person.
Yeah.
So that's going to be next year.
That's going to be, I think next year, everybody got to go.
So in order to get certification, you have to travel to Okinawa. So it's a financial commitment, right? So fundraising is important, and community support for concerts and donations are very important too.
So what's happening with this year is that we've been told all of them, Shinji Shoe, this might be the last year, and you're going to be able to do virtual. And the year before that, we had even more people. And we didn't start. That's the reason why we have.
So, if I could, I'd like to call Kenten Ono Sensei out here. Kind of talk about the numbers. I mean, they've got the great numbers. People who have been so successful from the city. And so we have it's not a handful of people that passed Kongfu in 2021 and 22.
We only have a handful that go to Okinawa and spend the money. They took advantage of having the virtual Kongfu event this year and last year. And we had 30 something people last year between Hawaii and LA. And so this is not everybody, but the people who are here, we do have one from Seattle, one from Maui.
So everyone that's going to perform the next set passed one level of Kongfu. These are all your successful,
all the different levels.
Your successful to graduates.
The program show.
And those poor people going to sit Caesar for a long time.
Yeah.
Hi, Jobo.
So this is only the last 2 years. So shall we introduce them?
Yes, please.
So, Saiko Shio, that's the highest level test we take for Kongfu. And we got John Hewitt. And then Yushu Shio is the second test, or the, I should
Pusher is the last test, right? The test right before that is Yushu Show. So they gotta play between 10 songs, they gotta play four that year, and they pick two weeks before the test. And so we got Mindy Omi, Cassie Nakagawa, Tom Yamamoto, Devin Kawamura, and from Hilo via Maui, or Maui via Hilo, Jason Hondo. And then, one more cycle, well, this is just the Uta Sanshi. Or the different, they have all the different instruments as well as dance. So like some of the people you saw earlier, they just passed the first test for dance. The ones from LA, Texas. But we got June Wilton Sensei, she's one of our Shihans for Sanshi, but she also took a psycho show for Fuin. I got my students who, first of my three students who took Shinjinshu for Bucho, Okinawan fiddle here.
Yeah, I see that sign.
Kind of different. We got Sean Saroka, he's also a Shihan for Sanshi. We got Red Mania, also took Shinjinshu for Kucho. And Jason, the Hilo Maui guy, right? He also took Shinjinshu for Kucho, but he's going to play Sanshinku. And then in the back here, we got all the Shinjinshu who took last year and this year. We got Justin Higa. He's over at UCLA. He took the test in LA, actually. We got Salvador. We got Kento. We got Sean. Sean Tamoy is from here, then went to Maui, that's how we first learned Sanshi, and then back to Honolulu, and then now in Seattle. So he came to take the test and perform today. Got my youngest, my son, Kobe Oro, my oldest daughter, Cassie. My second daughter also took the test too, but she's living in Portland. Got my wife, Chris Oro. Got Doreen Okamura, Julia Okamura. She's also the Shihan Nakasone Dance Academy. Got Kylie, Brianne was the last year's Cherry Blossom Queen. We met Nakasone and Lauren Akamine, who just took Shinji Show this past year. So that's all we got, so they're gonna show us what they got. This is the first. Well, it's not really the first test. The song is from the first test, but they're going to play the entire song, and each group is going to play different parts of the songs depending on when they pass the test. So this is the song titled Nuhabushi. Tozo. Newport Bushy is